Chapter 24. Islamabad is what Kabul could have been. When they arrive, the hotel is very nice compared to Kabul. It even has a colored television and Sohrab starts watching. Farid leaves because he wants to go back to his children, Amir gives him $2,000, and Farid almost cries. They never see each other again. Amir falls asleep and wakes up. Sohrab is gone. He goes downstairs and talks to the receptionist who hasn't seen Sohrab. They drive to the mosque and Sohrab is sitting outside. He wants to know if God will forgive him for hurting Assef. Amir says he will, that some people are just bad, and Hassan had hurt that guy too, protecting Amir, and that Hassan would be proud of him. Sohrab says he misses his parents and Rahim Khan, but he's glad they aren't there so they wouldn't know how dirty he is. Amir holds him as he cries and asks if he wants to come to America with him. Sohrab doesn't answer, but just cries. They don't talk about it for another week and they go for a picnic. While there, they are watching hawks and Sohrab asks if there are hawks in San Francisco. When they are eating, Amir tells Sohrab that he and Hassan are brothers. Sohrab said he didn't know that, and Amir says they didn't know either, and he only learned about it recently. He then tells him that Baba loved both of them equally, but differently. Amir and Sohrab talk about San Francisco that night, and Amir asks if he thought about it. Sohrab said he's scared that they will get tired of him. Amir says he won't, he's his nephew, and that Saraya is a kind woman and that she will love him dearly. The next morning, Amir calls Saraya and tells her everything. She wants him to bring Sohrab home and really wants to meet him. She promises not to tell her parents who Sohrab is until Amir can do it himself. Amir and Sohrab go to the embassy and meet Mr. Andrews. After hearing a changed version of the story, Andrews says it's unlikely he'll be able to adopt. Sohrab is not technically an orphan because there are no death certificates to Sohrab's parents, or paperwork proving that they are related. Amir says in English how Sohrab was sexually assaulted, and Andrews says he's sorry, but the law is the law. As Amir leaves, he asks if Andrews ever had a child and that someone should work there who knows what it's like. Andrews gives him the number of an immigration lawyer and Amir leaves. As Amir leaves, he mentions how Andrews is rude, and the secretary comments how he hasn't been the same since his daughter committed suicide. Back at the hotel, Sohrab has been taking really long baths. Amir calls Saraya and she's really excited about Sohrab. She's also been calling people to get adoption help. They meet Mr. Faisal and he seems disorganized, but it turns out Mr. Andrews already called ahead and told him the story. Amir then tells Faisal everything. Mr. Faisal says it's hard, but there are a few options. One is to stay in Pakistan for 2 years, and the other is to put Sohrab back in the orphanage for a little while until they can get the paperwork in order. Amir tells all this to Sohrab after, but Sohrab is terrified and cries himself to sleep, mad because Amir said he'd never have to go back to an orphanage. Amir also falls asleep. He wakes up with a phone call. Saraya has worked out a way that once they get Sohrab to America, they can apply for a visa, so he won't have to get put back in an orphanage. Amir goes to Sohrab, who's taking a bath, but when he opens the door, he screams until an ambulance arrives.